Follow the trench! It leads you to the rendezvous!
Beat that roll, my friend.
There you have it, huh?
Ah, fate's a bastard. I'm on patrol tonight, then. C'est la vie.
Here, drink this. Then I'm going to get you out of here.
Get you back to safety. Just hold on to me.
Ninth of July, 1700 hours. I'm in a state of agony. It cripples my body, captures my mind, bleeds my soul. This thing I've done, this thing. It is lunch in the mess hall currently. Oh, the thought of eating repulses me.
I thought I was the last one. You're trapped down here. A rat themselves ran and blew the exit behind them. You want to escape. You need to blow it back open. There's dynamite in the arsenal. Ah, and a handle to trigger it somewhere in the excavation site. Get them, and you can make it out.
Shit!
That thing, it's coming for me. Here, take this. Finish me off. Please. I want to die at the hands of a border soldier, not that monster. There's ammo in the pantry. Get it. Do the job, please.
Thank you.
Schließ es wieder. Bitte, bitte. Schließ es wieder. Es kommt.
9th of July, night. My conscience compels me now, as it failed to compel me then. I must do something, even if it costs me my own life. I must do something lest I never sleep again. I must do something or risk greeting hell itself as a relief. I must do something. I go. Eighth of July, mid-afternoon. Joubert needs a scout for tonight. Routine patrol. Out to the communication wires and back. It'll be cloudy. Good cover. Easiest patrol possible. Sergeant wants me or Augustin to go. He still suspects one of us might have been with the mutineers. But I won't be going. How can I be so sure? Well, Augustin has agreed to a friendly game of chance to determine which of us it will be. And, using an old sleight of hand trick, there's no way I'll lose. No, Augustin doesn't have a chance because I'll ensure he doesn't. Me? A scoundrel? Perhaps. But when he returns and I remind him of the time he pissed in my flask, or the mysterious lice that appeared in my bunk, or the incident with that barmaid. Well, I laughed in those cases, and he'll laugh in this one. Ninth of July. I do not know the time, but dusk has fallen, and still, of course, no word. When I asked the sergeant, he shrugged, as if I was asking about when it might next rain. These fools around me, laughing, drinking, arguing. Do they know what I've done? Do they suspect it? I feel they must all be guilty of something. And yet, they laugh, drink, argue. God knows what I've done. I wonder if his judgment could be worse than my own.
one left. The code is 1-0-6-4. To anyone left, the code is 1-0-6-4. Please, I hope that you can hear me. I hope that you can forgive me. The Arsenal code is 1-0-6-4.
11th of July, 1916. Dusk. I sit now at the bedside of my dear friend, Henri Clément. The doctor has left, but I remain. I feel I must record the extraordinary twists of fate and fortune that have led me to be here. Breathing. Alive. Strong and well. While Henri lies unconscious, fighting for his life. It starts days ago, on a night patrol. I fell into some kind of pit. I was injured, unable to move, unable to escape. By all rights, it should have been my tomb. I cried for help, screamed myself hoarse. The effort left me parched, exhausted, and still alone. As the next night fell, as I cried what might have been my last cry for help, I could see the stars high, high above, beautiful, indifferent. And then Clément's face appeared at the top of the pit. He lowered himself to me, found a trickle of spring water there and had me drink from it. It was cool and crisp with a strange, sweet taste. Never has water felt more nourishing than that, administered by a dear friend's hand. I was saved. But of course, that is not the last twist fate's blade would stab into my back. 11th of July, 1916. Night. Later now, I continue my tale. As Clément carried me across no man's land, fate struck again. A German outpost spotted us. Gunfire. Explosions. Desperation. And as the air cleared, I pulled myself to my feet and saw that Henri was wounded. Blood pouring from his head, his eyes glassy. He was fading. I do not know where I found the strength to carry him, but carry him I did, all the way back to our bunker. 12th July, 1916. Morning. Woke this morning and realized that a toy I purchased for my son is gone. I promised him I'd bring him something home from the front, so I brought him a stuffed rabbit from a local shop. A rabbit because he thinks he's so fast. It must have fallen from my pack when I fell into the crater. The thought of that stuffed rabbit lying in that crater, rain and weather matting its fur, unloved, forgotten, totally alone, lost forever. It fills me with profound hopelessness. 12th July, 1916. Afternoon. Spoke to the doctor. He told me Henri woke in the night and had no recollection of the events in the crater. Indeed, he seemed even confused as to where he was. Aside from this disturbing news, I'm feeling rather good. Stronger and stronger. As if the whole ordeal has filled both my body and soul with new purpose.
Thank you. Thank you. It all gets lost in a terrible twirl. Can't see the sun. All the black smoke. Can't see the dirt for all the dead folk. Can't see the ocean.
Seek is over.
Vision's gone and gone's the vision. Vision's gone and gone's the vision. Come here. Let me show you what I have seen.
Thank you. Ah.